time. Everybody stand up for my town and yours. You ready for sure? From the field to the war, you ready for war. This is 845. Varsity man up. It's game time. Everybody stand up for my town and yours. You ready for sure? From the field to the war, you ready for war.
Hello, and welcome to the Varsity 845 Spring Sports Show. I'm your host, Ken McMillan. Every week, we will bring you video highlights from high school action in our region and keep you up to date with the latest news and trends. Here's what's happening. In boys golf action, Monroe Woodbury and Warwick met in a matchup of two top teams at windswept Warwick Country Club. Monroe Woodbury remained unbeaten with an 11-stroke victory over Warwick. Colby Lewis, Tom McHugh, and Sean O'Shea each shot 5 over par to lead the Crusaders. Monroe Woodbury won its first 8 matches and has one of the deepest lineups in Section 9 history. Coach Pat Bullock could send as many as 10 golfers to the league championships on May 12th at the Swan Lake Golf and Country Club. Now on to baseball. Newburgh Free Academy was unbeaten heading into Tuesday's game with Pine Bush, but no more. Pine Bush jumped out to a 7-0 lead in the first two innings and won the key matchup 8-4. Carlos Guzman scattered 8 hits for Pine Bush, and Eric Eichner had 3 hits and 3 runs for the Bushmen. Brandon Benedetto and Chris Fry had 2 hits for Newburgh, which falls to 10-1. If you're starting to think about sectional tournament sleepers, baseball writer Kevin Witt says add Middletown to that list. The Middies handed Kingston its first loss of the season, 7-0. Jay Smith had 2 hits and knocked in 2 runs for Middletown. Steve Knopf has been the team's best pitcher, and Kevin says second-year coach Justin Sturge has Middletown moving in the right direction. Turning to boys lacrosse, two of the hottest teams in Section 9 are Warwick at 7-0 and Monroe Woodbury at 8-1. Kingston is the perennial heavy hitter in Class A, and Valley Central won the title last year. But many coaches consider Warwick the favorite this season and expect Monroe Woodbury to be a player. Middletown has struggled, but the Middies picked up their second win of the year on Tuesday, beating Newburgh 5-4. In track and field action, Monroe Woodbury has a lot to be proud of as we approach the halfway mark. Megan Patrick-Nelly is ranked 4th in the nation in the 800-meter run, and Justin McCollin is one of the top sprinters in the state. Newburgh Free Academy jumpers Jen Mitchell and Doris Little are both top-ranked in the state, and so is pole vaulter Jenna Marione of Warwick. And keep an eye on Cornwall distance sensation Ashlyn Cuff. The secret to successful softball pitching is the ability to change the delivery of the ball and baffle the hitters. Softball writer Justin Rodriguez visited with Goshen's Chelsea Locatel to discuss the fine points of pitching.
Goshen's Chelsea Locatel is one of the top pitchers in Section 9. She went 18-3 with a 0.68 ERA last season, leading Goshen to its first Section 9 title in school history. Once again, Locatel, a junior, has Goshen in contention. She entered Tuesday's showdown against Port Jervis with a 5-1 record. Locatel, last year's Varsity 845 Player of the Year, took some time before Monday's game at crosstown rival John S. Burke Catholic to talk about her pitches and, more importantly, what makes them so effective.
I throw a riser by putting my fingers like this, and then I flip it up for the curve like this, and I take a little lean on my release. Most of the time it'll come in on a batter and then split at the last minute. I throw my changeup the same way as my fastball. I grip it like this, and instead of going this way, I go this way when I release it.
How devastating is that pitch? Like for?
It gets batters most of the time.
Locatel had all her pitches working against Burke on Monday. She threw a no-hitter with 13 strikeouts, leading Goshen to a 7-0 win. For Varsity 845 in Goshen, this is Justin Rodriguez.
That's it for this week's edition of the Varsity 845 Spring Show. Next week, we take a look at the fine art of hurdling on the track. Thanks for watching.